Welcome to this year in review of sleep medicine. We're going to look at some of the top news stories in sleep medicine from 2024. I'm Dr. Nishi Bhopal. I'm a physician who's board certified in sleep medicine and psychiatry. I'm the founder of Pacific Integrative Psychiatry in California. We see patients all across the state of California for anxiety and sleep issues. And I'm also the founder of IntraBalance, which is an online educational platform for physicians to learn sleep medicine. And I do that through a YouTube channel and online courses. So today I'm going to share some of the top news stories in sleep medicine, and we'll look at some exciting things to come for 2025. All right, so let's jump in. The first story I'm going to share is about the new restless leg syndrome guidelines. Now, this is really important for all physicians to know, whether you are a sleep doctor or if you're working in primary care or another specialty, because there have been some big changes in terms of what's recommended for restless leg syndrome. The AASM, American Academy of Sleep Medicine, no longer recommends using dopamine agonists as first-line treatment for RLS. This is because of the long-term risks of augmentation. This is a reversal from 2012 guidelines, which had prioritized dopamine agonists for restless leg syndrome treatment. Now, why did they make this change? Well, augmentation occurs in about 40 to 70% of patients on dopamine agonists over the course of 10 years. So now what's recommended, instead of starting with a dopamine agonist, is an alpha-2 delta ligand, so something like gabapentin or pregabalin, and intravenous iron is now preferred. There is a new emphasis on screening for iron deficiency, and you want to be screening for ferritin and transferrin saturation. You can see the Restless Leg Syndrome Foundation guidelines on how to properly assess iron levels. There is a way to do it, including fasting, doing it with a CBC, and the ferritin and transferrin saturation, as I mentioned. Brain iron deficiency is identified as a key factor in RLS and is often underrecognized by clinicians. There's also non-pharmacological options for RLS, including the NIDRA system, which is FDA cleared, which is recommended for moderate to severe RLS, especially in patients who have augmentation. If you have patients who are already on a dopamine agonist, there's a few recommendations. You can consider discontinuing and tapering them off with informed consent and switching them to a first-line agent, like one of those alpha-2 delta ligands. Or if your patient is stable, they may remain on low doses, providing that you're monitoring for augmentation. Take a look at the AASM recommendations for the updated guidelines. The second big story of 2024 is drug therapy for obstructive sleep apnea. Now, you may have already heard about this with all these new medications on the market for weight loss. Eli Lilly announced that its weight loss drug ZepBound, or tirzepatide, reduced the severity of obstructive sleep apnea by up to 63% in adults with obesity in 2 phase 3 trials. The drug improved sleep apnea symptoms in patients using and not using PAP therapy. Lilly is going to seek FDA approval by the end of this year for the use of ZepBound in obstructive sleep apnea. So the trials demonstrated that ZepBound not only decreased the AHI, or the apnea hypopnea index, but it also reduced body weight. Now let's look at the study results in a bit more detail. ZepBound reduced OSA severity by up to 63% in adults with obesity, and it's shown that it was helpful in patients with moderate to severe sleep apnea. Participants experienced a mean body weight reduction of about 20% from baseline. And so overall, the drug decreased AHI, or the obstructive sleep apnea severity, while improving overall weight management. So this is a big change in the world of sleep apnea treatment, where our first-line gold standard treatment remains CPAP, or PAP therapy, positive airway pressure therapy. But we're seeing an exciting emergence of new options, including medications that can be really supportive in patients who are struggling with sleep apnea, because as we know, not everyone is able to tolerate CPAP. So we'll see what's to come for next year. Now, the third big news story that I want to share is with regards to Apple Watch detection of obstructive sleep apnea. Many of your patients are likely using some form of wearable, whether it's an Apple Watch, a Fitbit, or an Oura ring, or some other type of wearable to either track fitness, sleep, or both. So Apple is the second company to receive FDA approval for a smartwatch that detects sleep apnea. The first company to do so was Samsung, which received FDA approval in February 2024 for the health monitor app on its Samsung Galaxy watch. Now, FDA approval does not mean that the device is considered a diagnostic tool, but it can be a really useful screening tool for patients who may have symptoms of sleep apnea. The Apple Watch is able to track heart rate, blood oxygen, and sleep patterns with their built-in sensors. And the study suggests that Apple Watch may help identify sleep apnea risk. But again, they lack clinical validation, so they're not a diagnostic tool or a substitute for a sleep study. So for patients who come in with that data, professional testing and treatment are necessary to confirm the sleep apnea diagnosis and to inform treatment. So it's important to inform your patients that Apple Watch can complement their sleep health awareness, but do not replace or provide a substitute for professional evaluation. So we've got the new RLS guidelines, we've got some drug developments for treatment of OSA, and then we've got this rise in wearables helping patients with sleep and understanding sleep health. So what's on the horizon for 2025? Well, artificial intelligence is revolutionizing industries across the globe, from finance to healthcare. It's transforming everything from customer service to life-saving medical diagnoses. And indeed, in sleep medicine, we are seeing an increase in artificial intelligence and some really exciting capabilities to enhance clinical practice. So AI is set to enhance diagnosis and treatment by analyzing sleep patterns. It can help to personalize care and potentially predict sleep disorders with a high degree of accuracy. So in terms of sleep apnea diagnosis, AI models using ECG, pulse oximetry, and sound signals show a high diagnostic accuracy. It can classify types of sleep apnea, obstructive and central sleep apnea, and it can predict severity to help improve personalization of treatment. In terms of sleep staging, AI helps to automate scoring of sleep stages from the PSG, which is quite a labor-intensive process currently the way that it's being done. So this is going to reduce labor and variability in sleep scoring because many times this can be subjective. So we're removing some of that subjectivity and enhancing accuracy, which is going to be helpful for improving accuracy and efficiency both in clinical and research settings. And we were talking about consumer technologies and wearables. So AI integration in these consumer sleep technologies allows for real-time sleep monitoring outside of sleep clinic. So it helps to support home-based interventions, make sleep medicine more broadly accessible to patients to enhance their understanding of their sleep, and also support your clinical work. There's more tracking and real-time data that we can get to best support our patients with personalized interventions. Thank you for your attention today. I hope this enlightened your understanding of what's happening in sleep medicine and what's to come. I'm really excited to see the changes for 2025. Sleep medicine is a rapidly growing and changing specialty, so there's lots of new developments. And with the increased attention from consumers and patients on sleep medicine and the growing recognition of the importance of sleep on a multitude of different physical and mental health conditions, we're seeing much more attention being paid to this area. So I'm excited to see what's to come. And thank you for joining me today.